Your size of your stomach is one fist on top of another, right? That's it. That's it, baby. You go out to dinner. You have seltzer or water or wine, whichever. Then you have a salad, a little tossed salad. Then you have a piece of bread. Guess what? You're full. But that's not what we do. We then get the plate and we go to the restaurants that offer the most food because that keeps the customers coming back. So now we're at a half of a pound of macaroni if we have it, a pasta meal. Then we have about 6 or 8 ounces of protein. If it's fish, chicken, it's 10. Fish is 10 ounces usually they give you, 6 to 10 ounces. And prime rib, get your 12-ounce steak. 12 ounces, fair? 12 ounces. Then you have a vegetable. You don't want to seem like you're eating everything, so you leave some things on your plate. Then you go to dessert, and then you share dessert because you're on a diet. Right? Oh, on a diet. And that waitress will eyeball who's going to say yes to a dessert because everybody else will fall in suit. So that is pretty much simple that if you're eating a little bit more than this, visually, let's take a look at that.
I think Marcie is a wonderful presenter. She's dynamic, energetic, engages the audience, really reaches out to people on a number of levels, and makes it personal.
100% above and beyond anything that we could have expected. We're actually looking into bringing you back for continuing education for our employees.
The biggest thing that I think really pushes people is what I call a condition called PMS. Everybody knows what PMS is, right? Men don't believe in it, and women blame it on everything, right? But quite frankly, it's not PMS. It's personal motivational standards. What pushes you? This PMS, or personal motivational standards, either gets in your way and drags you down, or it is the factor that drives you. It's what personally motivates you. What's your standards? What's your style? What's your system? And you got to know what that is. And if you don't know what that is, then you will then be dragged down. So you have to be clear. And how do you do that? Well, there's a couple things. I have something that's called set up for success. Even if it's an hour a week, make sure you write down, get some visual cues of what you're looking at, what you want to do. Just a little bit. I know it's so hard. You're going to school. You got kids. You got a house. You got to make money. You got to do this. You got to do that. But find 1 hour, if you're not doing what you want to do, to get into what you really, really, really in love with. You know, there's this one person that said, when there is no path, make one. One of them said that? Hannibal Lecter. I like it! I like it, though! Hannibal Lecter! A little person who makes my nickname is Bulldozer.
I think that she definitely walks the walk, and what I really enjoyed about her as a person was the fact that you know, she was straightforward. She was direct, blunt, somebody that could really motivate you.
I thought it was great. I thought the everybody in the company got a lot out of all these sessions. You were very interactive. You got people involved, excited. Your energy is up, and everybody loved you.
When your heart pumps fast, it's trying to get that blood through your system, and as you get in better shape, it doesn't have to work so hard. But what's most important is to have fun. Guys generally gain weight not because they overeat, but it's because they become more inactive. While you're athletes in high school and some of you athletes in college, that's when you stop and your career begins at 25 to 35, and you're more sedentary. Guys gain weight for inactivity. Women gain weight usually because we overeat. So what guys need to be thinking about is more activity and watch the diet a little bit more. Guys are more successful when they're in a competition. So is there a competitive way that you can get involved in physical activity, race against somebody, join a charity event, do something, because that'll kick up your competition and you'll maintain a little bit more gumption and adhere to the program a little bit more. There's two types of cells. There's the muscle cells and the fat cells. I shouldn't do that one, huh? XO. XY. You have muscle cells and then you have fat cells. You're born with X amount of muscle cells. Men get to build more muscle cells and fat cells in adolescence. Women get to build more fat cells in pregnancy. So we're the lucky ones. We get to develop more fat cells, and you guys get to develop more muscle cells.